This is Manabu Farms, reminding you, be productive with the space you have around you. Stop growing grass and grow some food. Feed the community around you.
Hello everybody. I noticed in my last video with some of the comments I got that I didn't give enough detail on what's going on around here. So I wanted to quickly tell you the history of the farm and what's going on with it, and then maybe tell you a little bit about what's coming up in the future for us. To start with, we started this urban farm here 5 years ago. We give away 80% of our food to the needy, either through the local school program or to one of the elderly shelters, and then also on some of our kindness missions. I'm pretty bad with time, but I would say about a year and a half ago, the cops showed up at my door and they said they could smell my pot growing and wanted to see my pot grow. And so as a joke, I invited them in to see my pot grow because I was growing food under my house. I had four of the pot grow lights set up growing food, and obviously they were smelling some neighbor who was growing pot. And they told me I had to shut down my underground food grow because it wasn't up to code of the fire safety. Okay, thank you for saving my house. I don't want to burn it down. So I stopped growing food under my house, even though in the winter that's how I was supplying the food bank and other places with hundreds of pounds of food every month. So we started growing boxes outside, and we were growing boxes already. Then the city came in about, let's see, 6 months ago, a little more, and said that we could not live in the church because I run a church and a community farm, and the building is registered as a church property. Well, even though it's quite common for pastors to live in their church and it's quite common for monks to live in their temples and things like that, somehow my city has made a rule against that. So we said, okay, we will convert it over to a home. We'll call it a house. We'll convert the property to a residential, and I'll hold services in my house because you can't stop me from doing that. Well, they didn't like that idea, so what they did is they told me that to convert it to a house, I had to tear out my community garden, tear out my altar, my sweat lodge, and other things like that, to put in this huge, ridiculously huge, paved parking driveway and covered carport. And that's where we're at for about 6 months. We didn't do anything. We didn't garden. We were so depressed with that the city was just out to get us and out to get food growers. We were some criminal. And then it dawned on me that that's exactly what had been going on since the beginning. That's going on all over the world. And if I didn't fight, nobody would fight. So we decided we would fight. And instead of all the garden boxes we had tore up to put in the driveway, we said, forget it. We're going to throw in beds. We're just going to dig into the dirt and plant as much food as we possibly can. And that's pretty much where we're at. Since then, we've told the city that we're going to stay a church. They can't tell us we can't live in our church. And we're going to keep our garden the way it is. Who knows what the next attack is going to be, how they're going to come at us. Most likely they're going to come at us again with something saying by their law that we cannot live on holy land, which I'm sure outrages you as much as outrages me and as much as outrages them trying to tear down a garden for a parking lot. But what it has done is inspired us to get back to fighting, back to doing more videos, back to doing more gardening. And I thank my city. And I want to tell you first off, or I want to end with a few things. First off, my city is one of the most wonderful cities to live in. I am not attacking my city. I'm not attacking my city council. They are following laws that they have written, and those laws are what I'm attacking. They need to be changed. Not my city. My city is a wonderful town. I love Humboldt. I chose to retire here after living in 49 out of the 50 states and being in 5 different countries. This is where I chose to settle down because it is the best county that exists. In my opinion. Sorry to down on your county. anyways, upcoming shows. First off, we're going to be doing F5, which is Fun Fast Facts from Food. Little animated series with food talking at you, giving you facts that hopefully the common farmer doesn't know. Also, we're going to be doing a highlight the hero of the garden. I haven't come up with a good name, maybe you can submit one down below, but basically what we're going to do is we're going to highlight each week a different YouTube farmer out there who is trying to grow good food and do good things, but isn't getting those tens of thousands of subscribers like we know they should get. And then the third video is just going to be updates. So every week we're going to come out with three new videos, the F5 series, the hero of the garden, and then a garden update on how we're fighting the city. So stay tuned.